First takeoff on skis.
Welcome to the experimental ski build video, guys. We got some photos to start off our adventure here, cutting the sheet metal according to the templates. We've got plans for some experimental Zenith skis. We have never seen any flying in person, but we're going for it. And we're going to put these experimental skis onto a low-wing tricycle gear Zenith airplane, a CH-200, which is pretty unique. And the first day of cutting, we didn't have the right video format, so you got a bunch of photos here, but it's kind of self-explanatory, and the details are coming up, guys. If you stick to the end of the video, you'll see amazing test flight and great success. Enjoy.
Deburring the holes.
Is that ruler here?
Yeah.
Let me steal it.
Drinking on the job.
Okay, so we've cut a lot of holes. We've got side L channels that are gonna bind the bottom of the skis to the sidewalls. And we've gotta put heavy duty rivets. These are some pretty hard to squeeze rivets. In fact, we could not do it with muscle power, and we had to use a hydraulic press to squish these rivets. Eventually, we got a really high power rivet air gun, but you can see we're gonna use like a heavy duty hydraulic press to squish the side rivets in. Maybe the rivets we were using are just a little bit too big. We went one size smaller. We probably could have done it with an air hammer. But luckily this EAA hanger has a nice hydraulic press that saved our butt with those heavy duty sidewall rivets. It's still a lot of work. There are hundreds of rivets.
Nice. Last two.
Pretty good for a first attempt. Here, let's squish this one. Uh-oh, it's not gonna work.
Oh, shit.
Oh, good point. Do you have a longer...
That's gonna be super attachment. Long.
Ooh.
So we got that sorted out, and we got all the rivets pushed in the longer pole. I spent a few nights finishing the rivets on the sides and bottoms, and now we're back as a team together working on the top parts. Great progress.
Still a bit more.
It's touching here, on the head of the...
You know what?
That thing.
Okay, then
it needs to go down more.
Down a bit, yes.
You can see in this video a couple of learning takeaways and modifications from the plans. Where the axle goes through the two sidewalls, Bruce was able to weld that. And we used heavier duty aluminum for the sidewalls, and that axle tube itself was never in the plans. So we added a lot of extra strength. And then the notches that Ari is cutting out there around the rivets are a pain in the butt. If you had flush rivets at the tail piece, then there would be no interference with the
this
top.
This side is this good, so it's touching here.
Again.
Do you want to cut that out? Cut that corner out?
I have it. Perfect.
Try
one more time.
It's a long video.
We can edit. We'll have no choice.
It's good to show the process. It's not always easy to build something.
Still?
Not touching
not
here.
So, you and you. And then okay, you're fine.
Nice. Pop those rivets.
When does it pop some rivets?
No, I'll just take some video.
Alrighty.
I got the feeling already. It's pretty awesome. So much easier than...
Oh, yes it is.
Easier than anything. But those rivets cost $1 each. These Cherry Max Aviation rivets. Unbelievable.
To get it because these fit in nicely.
So, but squish it through the plastic.
You think it's easy?
That's me putting 110%.
You want pliers to squish it through?
No, I think...
Well, because if it's the right size for the metal hole, then the only problem is the plastic is self-healing. It's you know what I mean?
Try putting it in.
With a vice grip or something, I could probably get it through.
Okay.
Or pliers?
Yeah.
Should be able to, right? Squish it through?
Sure.
Vice grip. Yeah. Okay.
It is not too big of a hole now for this. That hole's a little too big, but it's just one.
Did it mushroom though? Looks like it did. Looks like it's
still gonna hold it.
It's still gonna hold the plastic on. That mushroom looks pretty good.
Yeah, that one does look good. Should I fix this one up a bit?
Sure.
There we go.
Oh yeah. You're killing it, man. Keep going.
Okay, I'm really happy. This is...
Progress is fantastic. This is nice. Great success.
So here we are. Fabrication is finished. There's one more big step, putting all the rigging together, connecting the bungees, the safety wires to the landing gear legs, and making sure the axle holes fit over the axles with the right diameter, creating some plastic bushings for that. Bruce and Ari spent a couple nights working on that, and I wasn't there to record it. So we're gonna jump right to the test flight now.
Nice. Alright, you keep pushing, Jeff. We'll turn it.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
That's awesome, guys.
So to do a run-up, it's got to be a rolling run-up, or we got to tie the tail down. Which would you prefer?
For your safety, you should probably tie the tail down to get a good warm-up run, right?
Yeah, okay.
There's a winch cable. Or is there a rope?
I have a couple of toe straps. Yeah, we should try that.
Man, he's gonna take off.
Oh man, this is crazy.
Holy shit, that was a fast takeoff, man. Woo-wee. First takeoff on skis.
Skis look great so far.
Thank you. Everything looks perfect. The angle on the rigging's perfect, and you're gonna have no problem landing.
Okay, great, thanks.
It's a beautiful plane on skis. Oh my god, it looks so good. Oh man, we're gonna have a lot of fun this winter, or next winter, man. Gary, we gotta do your plane next. Awesome. So you can turn around. Woohoo! Bravo! Great success, big success.
Yeah.
Congratulations.
Oh, thanks. So, learned a couple things though.
Okay.
One, I thought the ski fell off when I was in the downwind.
Yeah.
So I was doing 120.
Yeah.
Indicated.
Wow.
And that's way too fast.
Yeah.
Because the wind was blowing me, so I was taking up some speed, and then I leveled off at 13, and I still climbed up to 14, but I'm still accelerating.
Wow.
And then all of a sudden, the ski wanted to go this way, then that way. So I was compensating with the rudder. So I was doing like this in the downwind for a second until I realized really quickly that I was too fast. So I pulled the throttle right out, and then I slowed down, and then it was like normal. But luckily, it was the same feeling as if you do a side slip.
Okay.
And the nose wheel wants to move over.
Yeah.
So that was a good eye opener.
So at high speed, the ski did catch some crosswind.
Some air. And I was in a turn, right? I was just turning crosswind to downwind.
Right.
And that's when it was like, whoa! Because I was in a turn already.
120. I mean, I almost never fly 120 indicated. So the winter performance must be really good.
Really good. How was my landing? It felt really soft.
Your landing was awesome.
Right. Okay.
Takeoff was awesome. Your whole flight was perfect, man.
Okay, and shutdown was, a 25 minute flight.
Awesome. Awesome skis.
For your logbook. Hey, for my logbook too, actually.
Awesome.
Hey, that was my first ski flight.
Yes. High five. Yeah, you did it, man.
Thanks for letting me fly your plane.
That was beautiful. Good video too.
Oh, I can't wait to send you the video. Oh man, that was fun.
Awesome.
Okay, so everything we know about